Hey everyone, this is Ipia Switcher, and welcome to another episode of Evanica. So in this episode, as you can guess, you see the tent over there, and I've met the Snake Crest, basically the Snake Crest, we call that the Snake Crest throne room where the Supreme Commander of Snake Crest used to be at Sadis. He's now dead, but hey, what do we have? I actually pretty much guessed where Simbers would be. Yeah, she's here. Where else? No. because she's the ultimate saint, so it's like for the ultimate saint, obviously, where else would she be but here? Well, how she got up here, I guess she used the portal. Wait. Was there a portal? Wait, actually how did Saint Silent even get here? I mean, how Esther and his waifus got here is using like some teleport device, right? I mean, not teleport device. I mean, Esther managed to use teleport. Yeah, using the power, the memories of his sisters to allow himself and his waifus to teleport to Sky Island. But how did Saint Silent get here? Does she have a potential power that allows her to come here? Or did someone else help send her here or something? I don't know. But I guess we'll find out maybe. So yeah, but Saint Silence. H scene. Saint Silence H scene, let's go. The party found a tent inexplicably set up in the dungeon. What's a tent doing here? And in Snake Crest base of all places. On Sky Island of all places. Alright, good to know, but I'd like to ask, why are you here? While the party was confounded, Silent popped out of the tent. Is it really that hard? I mean, hiding here, I mean, Sadis is already dead, so it's safe. But, yeah, of all places, why here though? You know? What about the saxophone? Silent took some baggage out of the tent and handed it to the party. We get the item first before the saxophone? No, saxophone first. Junk. Well, I mean, to a saint, it's useless, right? What? Wait, so we get the item before the chow making? Chow making? So, saxophone? How are we going to stop Saint Silent? Because Saint Silent is definitely the most experienced and the smartest of the three, but well, we'll see. Oh, she's okay with wish casting contraception magic? Okay. So Saint Silent wants to continue being a saint. Yeah, I mean, that makes sense.
どうせ 奥方様たちが孕んだ後に私たちも励むのですから、今のうちに鳴らしておくのも良いかと思います。
Become accustomed with the act, so becoming experienced. Right, that's Esther, yeah. Oh, please, I'll be fine. You sure about that? Alright, Esther to enter the tent. Okay. Well, of course, he's always ready. Then caressed Esther's, you know, swollen something through his pantsu with skill that should have been impossible for a virgin.
I'm
Calm down, Silent, though. This is what you care about, though, Silent? Because, yeah, share the experience with Cloud, because Cloud also has subsequent with Esther. You knew it, Kriga. He? What he? You mean you? I mean, you're the only one who can use contraception, or as in Esther using contraception. But I thought Silent said you can use contraception magic. Because I don't think Esther will use contraception, to be honest. He has never used contraception. Okay. Silent lowered her underpants and with moist eyes, you know, asked for Esther's thing. Right. Well, so is Silent going to give birth first after all? Well, I guess you'll find out soon. Yeah. Yeah, I guess we'll find out probably in the epilogue or something. Silent wiped up the river of milk pouring out of her. So, river of milk? So does that mean she's also soaked in milk? Like, soaked in the river of milk? Okay, Silent wiped up the river of milk pouring out of her, looked at the state of the tent and sighed. Basically, the whole tent is almost filled with milk too. That's kind of a bit overboard for a practice. Which puffed out her cheeks and glanced at Silent, but hardly appeared to threaten. Oh, is that you, Gregra? I'll be just dandy after my afternoon nap.
Oi, toshiori kusaku natteru zo. Masaka karetan janai daro na.
Because dandy is not usually a word that you a young person would say. Yeah.
Sore wa komaru. Hijouni komaru zo.
Tashikamete mimashou. What did we find out? What? Silent took Esther's hand and pressed it against her chest. Oh, that's another smart move by Silent. But yeah, Esther's fine. But what? Back from the dead? Well, I mean, when there's something that makes Esther turned on, you know, he'll wake up, yeah. You doubt your partner, okay, but I guess that's good. You're gonna believe another one of her lies again though, Rich? Okay, experiment. That's really her
treat?
Yeah, especially when it comes to two different people. Yuri! No, that's a really bad idea, Silent. Nobody does that. Yeah, that would really not end that. What if she's lying, Yuichi? Don't fall for her trap again. Oh, so now we at least know how old Silent is. She's in her 20s. Probably late 20s though, considering that she said she would like to have a child while she's still in her 20s. And then please try to get pregnant soon. So that means she's in her late 20s. The party was seen off by Silent as they left the tent. So what item do we get though? We got the item first before the saxophone. Papa Lemon takes care of both oily stains, also takes care of oily papas. Okay. And this one multi hit plus 20. Definitely would be perfect for Grigra. Yeah, so. Alright, so that's it. So that's all the. Yeah, that's all the. Saxophone scenes of all the three scenes. So we've completed the scene side quest, basically. Yeah, so. Yeah, that being said, yeah, this is a good place to stop for this episode. So. In the next two episodes or so, we'll be completing the last two Love Gauge scenes. Yes, the last two Love Gauge scenes involving the last, involving the remaining two heroines. Yes, the Grigra and Cap. So that one, that will be the next episode and the next, and the episode after the next, respectively. And after which, we can finally go on. Or rather continue with the main story as we go into the final dungeon of the game. Yes, so we're getting closer there, boys and girls. Getting closer to the finish, so it'll be one hell of a, it'll definitely be one heck of a ride once I reach the ending, but I think I'll save all those emotional words and all, yeah, for when we actually come to the end. It'll be really emotional, trust me on that. As you know, it's been slightly more than a year since I've started playing Ivanica. It's been a really long ride, yeah, but okay, I'll save all these words for when we actually come to the end. So, but that being said, either way, yeah, next episode we'll be accessing the next Love Gauge scene, that'll be Grigra's last Love Gauge scene. So, look forward to that, and I'll see you next time. See you then.